Next, write a program to generate the Fibonacci series up to n terms. Now, the general form of Fibonacci series is xn equal to xn minus 1 plus xn minus 2. That is, for any given term in the Fibonacci series is obtained by adding the previous two numbers in the series. So, the Fibonacci series first number is always 0 and the second number is 1. Remaining all other numbers can be computed by adding the previous two numbers. For example, the third number is sum of first number and second number, that is 0 plus 1, it becomes 1. Fourth number is the sum of third number and the second number, that is 1 plus 1, that's equal to 2. Like this, given any Fibonacci series number, we can compute it by adding the previous two numbers. Here, another example I have taken where I have to generate the Fibonacci series up to fourth term. So, starting from Fibonacci series number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, first number is always 0, second number is always 1. Now, third number is computed as by adding the Fibonacci series number second and the first one. So, this becomes 0 plus 1, that is 1. Next, Fibonacci series fourth number is previous number, that is Fibonacci number 3, and Fibonacci number second, that is 1 plus 1, that is 3. So, this I can generalize it as Fib of I. Here, I represents the nth Fibonacci number equal to Fib of I minus 1 plus Fib of I minus 2. So, I starts from 3, 4, so on up till nth term. So, first two numbers, if you know, remaining numbers we can compute by adding the previous two numbers. Now, here at each step, if you observe, what we are doing is we are just adding two numbers. The task here is just adding two numbers, and that result I am using it, and in the next time I'll have to add that previous result and previous to previous what result I have got, I'll have to add, then I'll get the current Fibonacci number. So, because the task is repeating, that is repetition of the addition task, so I can write the program in the loop or write the program making use of the loop. But each step result, I'll have to store it temporarily. So, we'll see the program in the next slide. Now, we'll see the program to generate the Fibonacci series up to n terms. Here, as we already discussed, the first Fibonacci number is 0 and second Fibonacci number is 1. So, we have made use of two variables here, Fib1 and Fib2, to store the first two numbers of the Fibonacci series. Fib1 is initialized to 0, Fib2 is initialized to 1. Then, I is used to as a counter to specify how many number of times the loop has to be executed. Then fib is used to store the, or fib is used to compute the remaining numbers of the series. And n is the nth Fibonacci number, which is the input given by the user. Now printf statements ask the user to enter the nth number of the Fibonacci series. Then using scanf, I am accepting the number and storing it in n. Next, I have to print the Fibonacci series. So, printf Fibonacci series up to nth term is. I have given that printf statement there. Below that, I want to display the numbers. So, first I am checking now if n is equal to 1. So, if the user has given input as 1, that means only the first number he wants to display. Then printf percentage d slash n comma fib1. So the first number is stored in variable fib1. I am just displaying that. Now if the user has not given input as 1, if the user has given any other input, or if the user has given input as 2, then if n is equal to 1, that is the condition becomes false, though control will go to the else if statement. In the else if statement, it will check whether the given input is equal to 2. If, for example, if the user has given input as 2, then the condition becomes true. Now I have to display the first two numbers of Fibonacci series, which are stored in fib1 and fib2. So in the printf statement there, I am displaying the first two Fibonacci series numbers, fib1 and fib2. Now, if the user has entered any number other than 1 and 2, then I have to compute the starting from 3rd, 4th till the nth number. So that is specified in the else part. that we'll see in the next slide. Now the user wants to display or see the first four numbers of the Fibonacci series. So now the user enters the input as 4, so that will be stored in n, and the printf Fibonacci series up to fourth term is printed. After that, the control will go to the if part. If n is equal to 1, the condition fails because n is 4, so it will control will go to the else if part. Again, else if n is equal to 2, now n is 4, so 4 is not equal to 2, so the control will come out and it will move to the default part, that is the else part. Now since the user has given input as 4, now I should start printing from first 1, 2, 3 and 4 Fibonacci numbers I will have to display. First 2 I have already initialized it as in fib1 and fib2 variable. So first I will display these two numbers, then I will compute the remaining Fibonacci series numbers. So printf %d/n %d/n, fib1, fib2, that is first 2 Fibonacci numbers I am displaying. After that, now I have to start computing the Fibonacci number starting from the third number till the nth number. In this case, nth number is 4. That's why here I equal to 3, because the calculation starts from the third number. First two numbers are default numbers which I already stored. So we'll have to start computing only from the third number. So I is equal to 3. Now I is less than or equal to n condition will be checked. Since n is 4, so I is 3. So 3 is less than or equal to 4 condition is true. So the control will go inside the for loop. Now here in the for loop, now I am computing the next number, that is the third number now. So fib equal to fib1 plus fib2, first two numbers initial numbers I am adding, so that fib1 plus fib2, that is equal to 0 plus 1, so the next number is 1, that is the third number of the Fibonacci series. Now after that, now the new number, that is the third Fibonacci number, I will move that number into fib2, and whatever was there in fib2 I will move to fib1. That is, for the next number I have to add the third number and the second number. So that is why the third number I am moving it into the previous number, that is fib2, and then whatever was there in fib2 I will move it into fib1. Next I'll print the third number, that is fib3. Okay, next now the control will move back and it will go to the update part, that is i++. Now once i is incremented by 1, I becomes 4. Now the condition is again checked, 4 is less than or equal to 4. The condition is true, so the control will go inside the loop. Now again fib equal to fib1 plus fib2. So now the value in fib2 is 1 and fib1 is 1. So 1 plus 1, that is 2. So now that new value, that is the fourth number, that I will move it into fib2, and then the third number which is stored in fib2 I will move it into fib1, so that for the next number, these two numbers if I add, I will get the fifth number. So now printf %d/n, fib. So now I am displaying the fourth number, that is 2. Then again the control will move back to the for loop into the update section. Now I is incremented by 1, I was 4, I will be updated to 5. Now the condition will be checked, 5 is less than or equal to 5. Now the condition becomes false, so the control will come out of the for loop and finally terminate the program. The iteration is shown there, first iteration and second iteration, that is the looping part. You can also try to do this using while loop. Okay, now we are supposed to write a program to find the largest and smallest of three numbers. Now this can be done by making use of if else, or if else ladder, nesting of if statements, or another way is by making use of the ternary operator. We can do this in just two lines, we can execute or we can perform this task. If you go for if else or nested if, the length of the program increases. So I have made use of the ternary operator, that is a question mark. We have already seen the syntax as such. Using that, we can easily find the largest and smallest of three numbers. So here we are supposed to accept three numbers from the user, then find out which is the smallest and which is the biggest. So now I have declared here all the variables as integer type A, B, C, that is to accept the three numbers. Then to store the biggest number, I have used here big, and to store the smallest number, I have made use of variable small. So first three numbers, I'll ask the user to enter three numbers, then store it in A, B and C respectively. Next, I have made use of the question mark, there is a ternary operator. So, and the ternary operator will return the smallest and will be stored in the variable small. So small equal to A is less than B. So first I am checking whether A is less than B. So if this condition is true, then whatever expression you are given following the question mark will be executed. If this condition is false, then whatever instruction you are given following the colon will be executed. So first bracket, within brackets what I given, that is the true part, and after the colon, second bracket, whatever you know instructions are given, that is the false part. Okay, so now for example, if I had given the input like 1, 2 and 3, these are the three inputs I have given. So A is 1, B is 2. So first now the condition is A is less than B will be checked. So 1 is less than 2 will be checked. 1 is less than 2 is true. So whatever instructions I have given following the question mark, that will be executed. So since I found out that A is less than B, now I have to check whether A is less than C or not. So that is why the control will go to the instruction given after question mark. There I am checking whether A is less than C. Now C is 3, A is 1, so 1 is less than C. So 1 is less than C means the condition is true. So again, following the question mark there, what I have given, that will be executed. Since 1 is less than 3 means A is less than C is true, that means smallest number is A. So following the question mark, I have given A. So A will be assigned to small. Similarly, the big or the largest number is also found out in the same way, only instead of A is less than B, I have made use of A is greater than B. Execute this program, check the output, and then try to do the same program using if else or else if ladder or nesting of if statements.